Hello, everybody, and welcome to SurgTech Academy. I want to remind you that if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel for the latest videos and notifications. Today, we're going to be talking about draping a patient in lithotomy position. Draping a patient in lithotomy position is one of those skills that is extremely scary for new people because we have a couple of unique drapes. We are so close to the patient, it becomes easy to contaminate, very easy to contaminate, in fact. First, let's talk about those unique drapes. The first two drapes that are pretty unique are the under buttocks drape and the leggings drapes. These drapes have put fear into the hearts of many a student and new employees, but I think that with a couple of practices, we can overcome our anxiety and see that it's not that hard. We also have towels, medium sheets, and a fenestrated drape. There are many cool fenestrated drapes out there that are specific to lithotomy position and do the best job of covering the patient. But as I don't possess one of those in the lab, I'm stuck with the regular laparotomy drape. So here we go. The surgeon has walked into the room. We have gowned and gloved them, and we are ready to drape. I have my good friend, Charlie the Mannequin, up in lithotomy position. I love him for doing that, so it means that I don't have to be up in lithotomy position. So what's first? Well, I've seen two methods. The first method is that, and the one described in the textbook, and the one I'm going to demonstrate is to place the under buttocks drape first. The second method, and the one I actually like, is placing the leggings first. Now, the reason I like the idea of placing the leggings first is because I've seen many techs use the under buttocks drape first, and I've seen most of them contaminate themselves on the stirrups. Years ago, when we used candy cane stirrups, when they were common, it wasn't such a big deal because the leg was more vertical and out of the way. But now with adjustable stirrups being utilized, it's far easier to contaminate your gown. So I think leggings should go first, but I'm going to put the under buttocks drape first. So manufacturers continue to do a great job for us by telling us where to place our hands. So with my hands underneath the cuff of the under buttocks drape, I'm going to place the drape completely under the buttocks so that only the cuff is barely visible underneath the patient. I'm going to be sure to be very careful and make sure that I am careful not to contaminate my sleeves on the stirrups. So I've got the under buttocks drape. It says left hand and right hand. How amazing is that? I'm going to let the drape completely fall. Left hand, right hand. I'm going to be careful not to contaminate, and I'm going to push it under the patient. There you go. Next, we're going to grab two towels that have been prepared ahead of time, and we're going to outline the surgical site. One drape to my surgeon. One drape for me. All right. Now, the great thing is that the companies and the manufacturers that make these drapes make it as easy as possible. They are kind enough to label the direction of the drape, the side it's supposed to be on, and oftentimes the anatomy it covers. So here we see on the leggings, it says left hand under the cuff and toe. So I'm going to go ahead and follow those directions and put my left hand under the cuff. I'm also going to grab my right hand on the toe and let the drape drop. Now, it is incredibly easy to not put this drape on correctly. So we want to start initially really, really well and take our time at the beginning so that we're sure to cover the whole stirrup. So with the toe in my right hand, I'm going to go under the cuff and try and create an opening. Then I'm going to slowly put the drape onto the stirrup, staying behind the cuff and pulling the toe. Again, this is not easy. Then I'm going to extend it onto the patient just like that. The next drape, again, left hand under the cuff and toe. So I'm going to put it, my hand there, grab the toe. I'm going to continue to put my, and I'm going to put my right hand under. And again, it's important to go slow and stay behind the cuff so that we get it completely on the stirrup and we don't contaminate. There we have it. Not too shabby. Now, when I think the stirrups are completely covered and I've extended the drapes on there, I'm going to go ahead and start and put a medium sheet on the patient. Medium sheet. We're going to make a cuff and drop. And then lastly, we have the fenestrated drape. Again, I only have a laparotomy drape, but there are other drapes out there that will completely cover the patient. Patient's head, patient's body. I'm going to put the hole right in the incision site, extend it to my surgeon. We're going to create a cuff. Go down. Completely extend the drape. Create a cuff and go forward. And there we have, folks, a completely draped patient in lithotomy position. At this point, I would pull my table up, throw off my cords, and we would begin the procedure. I'm Mike from SurgTech Academy, signing off and wishing you a great day in surgery and reminding you to be a superstar in your OR.